I'm only human, can't you see? I made a mistake. Please just look me in my face. Hi guys, welcome back to Celeste's Corner. Today I have a special guest. And this special guest is my boyfriend. As you guys can tell from the title below, this is the boyfriend tag. So, what is your name?
My name's Hector.
How old are you?
18, believe it or not.
Well, okay. When/where did we first meet?
We met at school, like our college. And the first time we actually met was in our first class. Interpersonal communications, yeah. And we had a formal handshake and everything, which was pretty fun.
Do you want to explain the activity that we were doing?
With the handshake?
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure like we had our names written on a card, and then we had to write on each corner of the card, like our favorite hobby or like something we do and all that. And I put on top of like the top left, I put airsoft, and
I was like, what's airsoft?
Yeah, she didn't know what airsoft was. And then she's like, well, what's airsoft? And I was like, it's an extreme sport. And so, which it is. But yeah, that's basically it.
Okay, who said I love you first?
Ooh.
It was you.
It was?
Yeah.
When?
I think it was like on the patio, on the third floor patio of our school.
How did I say it?
We were leaving each other, like, because it was time to go home.
And I said, I love you?
Yeah. He was like, love you. I'm like, oh, okay. What do you do?
She's like, oh, God.
Okay, what's one thing you wish that I didn't do?
One thing I wish you didn't do?
Yeah.
Ooh. There's a lot of things I wish you didn't do. I guess the one biggest thing.
Wait, there's a lot.
Yeah. No, like in terms of like annoying me, but no, like I think the biggest one. Yeah, yeah.
I annoy you a lot?
Most of the time. No, but like, okay, you know, I'm not even gonna sit here and explain it. It's like a good type.
Okay.
But I think like the biggest one is just like when we're in like a public setting and then we start getting loud with each other, but then you go that extra mile and get louder than me, and I'm just like, okay. Stop.
Because we're a very, like, playful couple. Like, yeah, like, we have no chill, so...
No.
We'll just be loud in public. Not loud, like, that sounds so bad. But, like, we're not, like, loud in public, but, like...
I mean, like, we can make you feel really awkward in, like, 2 seconds. But it's not, like, a bad thing. We're not serious about it. Like, I think when we really get serious, it's, like, it's more quiet.
But yeah.
That's basically it.
Where was our first date?
I know this. Hold on. Our first date, we actually went somewhere. The Christmas market, the distillery district.
Yeah, the Toronto Christmas market. I will leave that video link down below.
Yeah, it's really, yeah, it was a pretty cool night.
What eye color do I have?
It's like hazel, right?
Excuse me? And this is the moment that he knew he messed up.
Yeah.
My eyes are brown.
No. No. In like, in this lighting, yeah.
My eyes are brown.
There's like not enough lighting in this room for you to confirm that.
Okay, so when-
They're very light.
Okay, so I have a light brown eye.
Yeah, like hazelish.
Hazel's like greenish brownish.
Is that what that is?
Yeah.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is.
I don't think it is.
Dumb.
It's brown. Hazel. When people say hazel, you mean brown. No. Like, most of the time.
When I say brown, I mean brown. Like, that's my last name. Thank you very much. what TV show do I usually talk about?
The Vampire Diaries.
What else?
Is that what it's called?
Yeah.
You were talking about Pretty Little Liars a lot lately.
Yeah, because it's coming back in April.
Yeah.
What is my favorite drink at Starbucks?
It's one of those, what do you call it? Frappe?
Frappe?
Frappe? Frap? 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 Whatever.
Frappe.
Frappuccino. The caramel one.
The caramel frappuccino, good job!
Yeah, I know, I know.
What's my shoe size?
I don't know that. I've never asked that.
I know. That was just that. Yeah, okay. Well, how long have we been dating?
2 months. Couple days now?
Mm-hmm. What day is it today?
19th.
19th? So, yeah.
3 days.
2 months and 3 days today. How often do I make you angry?
Surprisingly, not a lot. Yeah, like, I guess the only time I get angry is when you get, like, moody for no reason. There's times when, like, we're having a really good day, and then I might say something that is irrelevant. I, like, just mention someone that doesn't matter. And then, yeah, just, you know, she gets moody, and then she just doesn't talk to me. And she's like, yeah, okay, sure. Like, really dry, and I'm just like, you know what? Like, good night.
Sorry. Okay. Okay, so we're out to eat. What kind of dressing do I get on my salad?
That's a question?
Yeah.
I don't even eat salads.
I know.
But you eat, like, Caesar dressing?
Sure. What's another one?
You don't mess with ranch. I don't. Oh, no. There's like I don't even know what it's called. I'm sorry.
Italian.
It's like a see-through brownish thing. I don't know what I'm talking about. Yeah.
There you go. Okay, so we go out to eat. What drink do I order?
Well, we're both really big fans of root beer. Yep. So, mostly that, but then sometimes she's a Pepsi lover, not a Coca-Cola lover, so I'm...
Oh yeah, Team Pepsi all the way.
No, I love Coca-Cola, that's where it's at, actually, so...
Whatever.
That's the divide.
Where was I born?
Canada.
Canada, where in Canada?
Again, I've never asked you that. I can't sit here and say I know. Where was I born?
You were born here in North York.
That's not, it was, no, actually, no.
Were you born in downtown Toronto?
Mm-hmm.
Why that far?
That's a good question. I never really thought about that, but it's just like...
That's something to ask your mom. Because, like, yeah. Choosing hospitals for, like, giving birth, like, that's a big... I don't know what I'm saying, but, like...
I know, far from where we live. And we used to live even farther, because we were more out. So, yeah.
What kind of cake do I like to get on my birthday?
Ice cream cake from Dairy Queen.
Yes. Did I play any sports?
You were a cheerleader.
Yep.
Is that a sport?
Yep.
Is it?
Yep.
I guess so. About how we actually started dating?
Okay, yeah, let's talk about that. Okay, so, like we said, we both go to the same school, both in the Child and Youth Care program at George Brown College, St. James campus. And so, like he said, we met in our intercom class, and we were just like, okay, like, hi, nice to meet you, with the awkward handshake. And I was just like, okay, like, this guy seems cool, whatever. And then I remember the girls that I was sitting with, they're like, yeah, like, I think he, like, has a thing for you. You know who I'm talking about?
Yeah, I know who you're talking about.
So, and I'm like, okay, like, I didn't really pay any attention to it.
Right.
And then, do you want to explain the whole...
Oh, my situation?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so, like, without getting too into it, because it's kind of personal, but basically, like, I just had, like, this really messed up previous relationship. And that went downhill very badly, and it was, like, 4 years of a relationship. So then I spent just 4 years by myself. And then I go to college, and I had a mindset where I was like, I don't really like people. Like, not that I'm antisocial or anything, like, I will have a conversation with people, but it's just like, my trust was a problem. And so I'm in here, and I'm like, you know, I don't really like anyone, I don't trust no one. And then,
like, I kind of had the same mind frame as well. It's like, I'm not here for friends, I'm not here for relationships, I'm here for school, and I want to become the best child and youth worker ever.
Yeah, of course. And from there, basically, after I just met her, I met a bunch of people. And then there's this one character in particular who I met, and yeah, the person basically like got the wrong message from like how I was behaving, and it was very weird because they kept saying how like they weren't looking for anything, and I'm like, I'm just trying to get this work done. I'm not asking you on a date or anything, you know. But basically that happened for a while, and it exploded, and it was horrible because then like I have this person telling me like.
Hardcore feeling.
Yeah, and I'm like, I don't know you. I'm sorry.
I guess the first week of school.
Yeah, I was like, what? I don't know you. Like, I can't do that. But whatever, it's like a month or... actually, it was towards the end of the semester when I finally started talking to yours truly over here. And this is when it gets a little bit juicy. So
I feel like we started really talking, like, the end of October, like, yeah. We were friends at the end of October, because yeah, you know, like, it makes me think of like Halloween, like, you know, Halloween, we were kind of like talking.
We were talking, and yeah. But like, it wasn't really like.
It was just a friendship.
Yeah, it was just really just,
and then like,
it was just
we also jokes. Had a third member of our friend group, so we were all just friends.
Yeah, and it was calm, it was something cool. But I think when we really started to get feels for each other was when... One day in the library, we were doing this thing to, like, for English. It was to set up... No, it was to learn how to do a proper essay or something like that, or search up things properly. And so she sat beside me, and we both discovered that the same person that I had problems with the first, like, week has a problem with her. And so, you know...
Even though I don't know you. I don't know you. Like, you're just some random girl in my class.
There you go. And so, what ended up happening was, like, we decided... now that we look at it, it was really immature and probably just, like, really mix-up, but we decided
but
to...
But it needed to be done. I'm sorry.
Yeah. We decided to pretend like we were something. Like, we were dating, but dating...
Or at least just slightly talking.
Yeah, and it was just to, like, bother said person. Yeah. and we kept getting warnings. We were like, hey, don't catch feelings now.
Yeah, like, close friends were like, hey, don't catch feelings. Like, this is all for jokes and, like, just to kind of get the other person away from him because he didn't really want her in his life. So we only did that just to mess with her, I guess.
We didn't do it with, like, bad intentions. I think it was really just for her to be like, oh, you know, he has someone, so, like, I'm not going to bother him. It worked, but at the end of the day, what happened was a lot of people gave us really positive support. They were really happy, if anything, and they kept telling us how they wanted us to be together. They were like, wow, if you guys are a couple, I'd support that all the way.
Yeah. Shout out to Andy.
Yeah, Andy's our number one supporter so far.
Yeah, because, like, even, like, so eventually she knew, like, we told her that it was just, like, a joke and what we were really doing. And she's like, well, you know what, like, kudos to you guys, but if you guys were ever actually together, like, I support that. Like, you guys are so cute together. And a lot of people said that to us. And a lot of people would come to me and, like, hey, you and Hector dating? And, like, I guess people came up to you, probably.
Yeah, people came up to me.
So, and then we're like, and, like, people would say that, like, right in front of both of us. So it was kind of, like, awkward.
It was awkward.
So I was like, oh.
We'd always look at each other and we'd be like, what were we saying?
We'd just be like, oh, maybe one day.
Possibly.
Possibly.
But we didn't really mean that, right? Until one day, we're in the library, we're doing work, and...
He had to go staple something.
Yeah.
And in our library, we in the middle of the library, there's, like, a little box, you can say, and that's where, like, all the printers are around the walls, and then there's also, like, the staple station. Mm-hmm. I was like, okay, well, I need to go staple my stuff too, so I'll come with you. And we left our other friends in the computer lab. Then...
So I had to go and staple something too. And if you go to George Brown, you know that place is, like, after hours, is barely anyone's there. So it was just me and her and no one else. I don't know what happened. I don't know what it was, but I got nervous.
Me too. And, like, talking about this afterwards, we've talked about this before. It's so weird because this is the moment that we caught feelings for each other. Like, and we both caught it at the same time. It's scary. It's weird.
It's weird.
It's sketchy.
Because then, like, I'm there, and in my head, like, so many thoughts are running up, like, I don't want to mess up, like, what if, like, I say something, like, dumb, right? Like, I need to be careful. And I was, like, trying to impress her, right? I'm trying to be funny and everything, and I kept saying things about how her dimples are cute and stuff, you know. And, like, and from there, it just, yeah.
And it just went uphill from there, and was it the same night that you asked me out?
No.
Oh, no, no. No, it wasn't.
It wasn't. It was, like, a week later.
Yeah, so we just continued, like, you know, talking, and then, you know, so, okay, so I live on one end, and he lives on the other end of the RT, of the
east
train,
and west.
Like, whatever, yeah, east and west. I live in the east, he lives in the west, and so I went home, he went home, and this guy at Kennedy Station, which is where I get off, he started, like, being very flirtatious with me. But thing is, he was a very nice guy. I can say that now. He was a very nice guy. Even after I told him, like, I used the I have a boyfriend card, even though we weren't dating yet. And then, so I was like, sorry, I have a boyfriend. He's like, okay, I respect that. But, you know, you're still a very beautiful girl and blah, 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 blah going on. Okay, anyways. So I texted him right after. I was like, so I just totally used the I have a boyfriend card. And, like, I was thinking about you. And, like, yeah, I was just like, I didn't want to mess anything up with him.
You didn't do it like that, though. The way she did it was, she said some guy came up to me and was being flirty. And the way she said it made me so jealous. And I, like, we weren't even anything, but I got so mad, like, in my head. I was like, what? Who is this guy? Like, you know? But I was like, wait, I remember she's not really mine. So right after she says that to me, and then she told me about how she used the boyfriend card, I was like, well, you know, can
since
we...
Since you used me.
Yeah, since you used me that way, can we make this official? Which, of course, there was, like, a bunch of, like, things we talked to each other before. Oh, yeah. We said yeah. Because, like, sure. We had to make sure we were okay with the fact that, you know, we have our own problems, and we have things to do, and we have goals that we've set for ourselves. So we can't really interfere with each other. So, like, there's a really big understanding between us.
And I first said, I'm like, if I say yes, you need to know that you are second place and first place is my education.
Mm-hmm.
So,
yeah.
And he agreed. So I said yes.
And today we're here.
Yeah, and 2 months later. And it feels so weird that it's 2 months. Like, I feel like it's been, like, forever, but
yeah,
it's going by slow, but it's okay. Like he said the other day, you were saying how, like, something about, like, it's going by slow, but we're able to enjoy second of it.
Yeah, because, like, when we look at it, it's been 2 months, right? But, like, it feels like we had so much things to do, and, like, there's still so much to do. And I think that's really good for both of us, because it's, like, at least we know that... Because I guess in the beginning, relationship is important. Because if you guys don't really get along in the beginning, then I don't know how you're going to do it in the long run. At least that's just
my thought. And arguments, like, they're going to happen.
Yeah,
we've already had our big argument.
Yeah.
And many more to come, for sure.
Yeah,
but,
oh yeah.
And we worked out our big issue.
Yeah.
So,
honestly, I think if you guys can, like, fix yourselves after big arguments, it's very, like, you know, powering. You guys really get together more. Cause
it brings you closer.
Yeah, right after when we fixed our stuff, I mean, we had an argument and we didn't talk to each other for a whole week. And then I say to her, like, you know, like, I miss you. I want you back. And then, like, I caught her quick, by the way. Don't, she's not as tough as she sounds, you know, because as soon as I said that, like, she looks down, she's smiling, she's blushing, and I'm like, okay,
yeah,
so I
he
know
pulled me out of class because it was break time. He tugged on my shirt and he's like, because he was sitting behind me, he's like, can we talk in the hallway? Like, shirtless.
No, she didn't. She was so happy. She was like, yeah. Like, I'm like, okay. See, now I spent, I'm going to tell all of you this, I spent 20 minutes staring at the back of her head and just like, what do I do? Like, not that creepily, like, not like that, but, like, I was like, do I throw something at her? How do I get her attention? And then I was like, yeah, I pull on her jacket. That's what everyone does. And I did it, and it worked. But she loves me, so.
Yeah, I do.
It's all good now.
So, yeah. Well, guys, That was the boyfriend tag. I hope you guys like that. We're like 22 minutes in, so this is gonna be a long video. So thank you for watching. And if you guys see more videos after this when we're wearing the same thing, and it's because we're gonna be filming a bunch of videos today, so you guys are gonna be seeing more of him. Now I have a filming buddy. So, all right, well, give this a thumbs up, subscribe, comment down below, share of all your social medias, and I'll see you guys next time on
Celeste's Corner.
Bye, guys.